Hello viewers, welcome to my channel Human Diseases and Genes. In this video, I will discuss about Wilson disease. Wilson disease was first reported by Dr. Samuel Alexander Jr. Wilson, a British neurologist, in 1912. Dr. Wilson described the disease as a rare genetic disorder characterized by copper accumulation in the liver, brain, and other tissues, leading to a range of neurological and hepatic symptoms. His detailed observations and clinical descriptions of the disease were foundation in recognizing and understanding Wilson disease. Wilson disease is a rare genetic disorder characterized by the accumulation of copper in various tissues, particularly the liver and brain. This buildup of copper leads to oxidative damage and affects multiple organ systems, resulting in a range of symptoms. Symptoms of Wilson disease are copper accumulation, hepatic, neurological, ocular symptoms, skeletal abnormalities, and renal issues. The disease is caused by mutations in the ATP7 gene, which encodes a copper transporting enzyme essential for the proper handling of the copper in the body. The defective enzyme leads to impaired copper excretion into bile and subsequently accumulation in the tissues. The liver is often the first organ affected in Wilson's disease, leading to symptoms such as hepatomegaly, that is enlarged liver, jaundice, abdominal pain, and liver cirrhosis. In some cases, the disease can present as acute liver failure, particularly in adolescent and young adults. Kayser-Fleischer rings are characteristic green or golden round rings around the cornea of the eye, caused by copper deposition. They are a key diagnostic feature of Wilson disease. Some individuals may experience bone and joint problems. Neurological manifestations may include tremors, dystonia, that is involuntary muscle contractions, dysarthria, that is speech difficulty, and problems with coordination and balance. Changes in behavior, mood swings, and cognitive decline can also occur. Kidney problems, including hematuria, that is blood in urine, and proteinuria, that is protein in urine, can occur due to copper accumulation. Wilson disease is estimated to occur in about 1 in 30,000 to 1 in 40,000 live births worldwide. The prevalence of Wilson disease is relatively consistent across different geographic regions, though specific figures can vary based on local population studies. Due to its rarity and the wide range of symptoms that can overlap with other conditions, Wilson disease may sometimes be underdiagnosed or misdiagnosed. Advances in genetic testing and increased awareness have improved diagnostic accuracy and earlier detection. Wilson disease is caused by mutations in the ATP7B gene, which is crucial for copper metabolism in the body. Gene is located on chromosome 30 at position 130146. This gene encodes a copper transporting ATPase, an enzyme responsible for transporting excess copper into bile for excretion from the liver. It also plays a role in regulating copper levels in the bloodstream and tissue. Mutations in the ATP7B gene led to defective copper transport and accumulation in various tissues, particularly the brain and liver, causing the symptoms of Wilson disease. it is inherited in an autosomal recessive manner. The diagnosis of Wilson disease is a combination of clinical suspicion, that is neurological and hepatic symptoms, low serum ceruloplasmin, elevated urinary copper, and genetic testing for ATP7B mutations. Kayser-Fleischer Rings observed on slit lamp exam alongside other findings strongly support the diagnosis. The therapy and management of Wilson disease aim to reduce copper accumulation in the body, prevent further organ damage, and address any complications arising from the disease. Treatment typically includes copper chelation, zinc therapy, and sometimes liver transplant. Regular monitoring is essential to assess the effectiveness of treatment and ensure the copper levels are appropriately managed. Serum ceruloplasmin and urinary copper levels should be regularly checked to monitor copper metabolism and adjust treatment. Liver function tests and liver imaging should be done periodically to assess liver damage and detect early cirrhosis or hepatic failure. Patients with neurological symptoms or psychiatric issues should be monitored for any changes in their condition. Wilson disease requires lifelong management with close monitoring for side effects of treatment and progression of the disease. Initial therapy of Wilson disease includes copper chelation, that is penicillamine or triterpentine to reduce copper level, zinc therapy to prevent copper absorption, avoid copper-rich food in case of liver failure or decompensated cirrhosis. Regular follow-up for copper level, liver function, and neurological status. Proper treatment allows many individuals with Wilson disease to lead a normal life provided they are diagnosed early and adhere to therapy. Patients with neurological and psychiatric manifestations of Wilson disease may require additional supportive treatment such as neuroleptic medications, antidepressant, or benzodiazepines for psychiatric symptoms. Physical therapy, speech therapy, and occupational therapy are often important in the management of motor symptoms like dystonia and dysarthria. In some cases where patients present with hepatic failure, aggressive treatment is required. This may include urgent chelation therapy and possibly liver transplantation. A liver transplant is the only definitive cure for the hepatic manifestation of Wilson disease. Once the transplant is performed, copper accumulation is largely resolved and the transplanted liver takes over copper metabolism. Zinc is used to prevent copper absorption from the gastrointestinal tract by inducing the production of metallothionein, a protein that binds copper and prevents its absorption. Zinc therapy is particularly useful in the maintenance phase after initial chelation therapy or as an alternative when chelation therapy is not well tolerated. Zinc is generally preferred in kids with less serious symptoms or for maintenance therapy in patients with stable disease. In children, therapy should be started as early as possible to prevent developmental issues. Monitoring growth and development is critical, and zinc is often the preferred treatment in children for long-term treatment or management. This is all about Wilson's disease. Remember, understanding disease helps us all stay healthier. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful and learned something new, please like this video. Don't forget to subscribe for more health insights. Share this video with friends or family to spread awareness. If you have any questions or personal experiences or stories with this disease, drop into the comment box. Don't miss my next video. Until then, stay informed and take care of your health. Thank you. Thank you very much.